Oh my god, these are so heavy.
I just posed for the thumbnail with these. These are heavy. I don't know what the hell is in here. That's what we're opening today. How exciting. Oh, hello. If you're new here, I am the Antichrist. Sometimes my devoted subjects do send me mail because I love mail. Also because I'm a physical media collector. That's usually what I talk about on this channel. So welcome if you're new. I know that was probably a lot to take in. Maybe sounded a little bit weird, but we're cool. We're a very cool cult. We just want to talk about horror movies before the apocalypse. So that's what I'm here to do. I have not done a subscriber mail unboxing, I think, since Christmas time, so it's been a little while. I would do it more often, but I actually share a P.O. box with my family, and they live up in Northern California, because those things are expensive, okay? I'm not shelling out for that, not yet, but it makes it kind of fun, because whenever I go up and I visit my parents, I get a bunch of mail from you guys to unbox. Oh, my dad is calling me. What do you want? Hello? I'm pretty sure I still have the option to record, even if it's on your thing, but we'll see, and if not, then I'll just make the call. Yeah, okay. Yeah, I did. I got it. Okay. Sounds good. Bye. My dad, bless him, does not know how Zoom works, despite the fact that he runs a company remotely. Funny story with these packages, my parents just came down to visit me this past weekend, and so my mom brought a bunch of the stuff in her suitcase with her. So I don't even know if this is all the mail that I've been sent lately. If you sent something and I don't open it today, I'm sorry. You'll probably have to wait on that. But with these packages, my mom had to open them herself first to see what was in them because she was getting on a plane and she did not check her baggage. She had to check just in case any of you weirdos sent me anything funky and strange. So if they look a little bit already opened, it's because they are. But she didn't tell me what was in them. I don't know what's in them. So let's get to opening. I will start with this one. I typically go from smallest to biggest, so that's just what we're gonna do today. Oh, my mom even retaped them. That was nice of her. Ah, we got some physical media. This is from, oh, Sandy Settle. She is an author. She sent me her book last year. Just a few films I've gotten upgrades for recently. If you have them already, please pass them on to someone else. Hope you enjoy. I appreciate it. Ooh, pretty postcard. I love that. I love when you guys leave little notes and like personal touches. And I'm looking right now at this stack, and this first one I have never heard of. This a Jane Fonda Barbarella Queen of the Galaxy movie. Maybe I had heard the name Barbarella before. I don't remember. I just know that Jane Fonda was a trailblazer in feminine fitness. This looks fantastic, actually. I think this is gonna be right up my alley. 1968. Wow. I would not have guessed, but thank you so much for that. Next up, oh, we have The Big Lebowski, which, oh my god, please do not pull out the pitchforks. I've never seen this film. I will hopefully be including it in my I Finally Watched series that I'm doing on my main channel over on Haunted Hippie. That's always linked down below, by the way. There's a whole lot of classics like this that I have somehow never seen in my life, this being one of them. So I've started a series to really crack down on myself and get more caught up. This helps out a lot. Thank you. Next up, we have Vincent Price in The Mask of the Red Death and Madhouse. Fun little double feature here. If you guys don't know, Vincent Price is one of my favorite horror actors of all time. The Mask of the Red Death and Madhouse, I've actually never seen either of these. Oh, and Peter Cushing is in Madhouse. Oh my god, amazing. These are two of his that I've never caught up on, which I feel like is fair because he starred in what, like over 130 movies or something. But I've heard really, really good things about The Mask of the Red Death. Thank you. And last up, we have Much Ado About Nothing. Another one of those classics that I've never seen. I'm pretty sure that every movie that Sandy sent me, I've never seen before. Is that Kenneth Branagh? It is Kenneth Branagh with Michael Keaton too, and Keanu Reeves and Emma Thompson and Denzel Washington. Holy hell. Now that's how you cast a Shakespeare adaptation. I think this will be right up my alley. Thank you so much for the nice little bundle. Next up, I will open this a package here. This doesn't have a name on it. I'm wondering if this is from a business. I wonder if this is like PR. Oh, it's clothing. Okay. Oh, and a DVD bundle. Let's see what the note says. Okay. Kylie, aka fellow physical media nerd, please find enclosed some cool, clean Canadian air with bonus melted snowflakes since it was snowing when I mailed this package to you. Thank you. Could really use it living out in LA. Two t-shirts and a DVD. Oh, I appreciate it. It wasn't signed with a name, so this was an anonymous package, but they recently upgraded their copy of Red Eye. I love this movie. I do already own it on DVD. So happy that you got the 4K upgrade. I wish that I had that too. You'll probably see this in an upcoming anti haul. This is a good one, so keep your eyes peeled on this channel and on the Poshmark. That's also always listed down below. I haven't mentioned that in this video. I sell all my anti haul stuff on Poshmark. Let's see what these shirts are though. I wonder if they'll fit me. They're a men's size small, so they look like they will. Oh my gosh, look at this Evil Dead 2 shirt. Has a little tagline, Dead by Dawn. That is lovely, that is. The other one, I have no idea what this could be. I was not expecting Evil Dead 2, I'll tell you that much. Ooh, Scares of Dracula. What even is this from an era of Dracula that I'm not familiar with? No, Scars of Dracula. Scars of Dracula. Oh, it's a new Hammer House of Horror collection. That actually makes so much sense because if you saw my most recent vlog to Universal Studios, I was showing off all their new Universal Classic Monster merch because they're making a huge comeback right now, or they're going to in the next 5 years. You mark my words, that's what it's all about. So it's perfect timing because I'll be talking about Dracula real soon. Next up, oh, we've got a package from John Larberg. He is a patron. He's also donated a fair amount to my upcoming short horror film, Light. A lot of appreciation for John on this channel. And this is also not the first bit of mail that he sent. You never know what it's gonna be with John, but more often than not, it is physical media. Oh my goodness, yep, I think it is. And with a note, it usually does come with one. He's really helping me fill out my steelbook collection, which just, Wait, I don't want to read on because I want to be surprised about what's in here. First up, we have this 4K edition of Army of Darkness. Is this a steelbook? I'm gonna lose my mind. I'm actually gonna, no, it's not a steelbook. Oh my god, I was gonna freak out. This is my favorite movie of the Evil Dead franchise, if you couldn't tell. But a sleeved 4K, that's definitely not what I own currently. I think I just have the regular Blu-ray from Scream Factory, so we got an upgrade. I believe this is the American remake of Let the Right One In. I'll be honest, I've not heard good things, but I am due to finally check this one out. Next up, oh, we got Drag Me to Hell. I do already own this movie, so again, keep your eye out for the next anti-haul for sure. Ooh, 30 Days of Night. This is an upgrade for me. So I do have this one on DVD, but of course, I prefer the Blu-ray. Next up, we've got Abraham Lincoln Vampire Hunter. Oh my god, this movie is so bad. I recently had found it on DVD and finally watched it for the first time, and I was so disappointed. I already got rid of my DVD, but now that I have it on Blu-ray, I'm like, maybe I should give it another chance. Oh, we got Gothica on a nice little clippy DVD, widescreen edition. I do already have this in, not the widescreen edition, but I have it on like literally a clippy DVD. If you're new here, I don't care that they're called snapper cases, okay? Don't correct me. Super underrated early 2000s horror movie, by the way. Next up, The Long Kiss Goodnight. Ooh, I have never seen this movie. Should this one be in my I Finally Watched series? Because this is a movie I feel like I've heard a lot about, especially because it stars Sam Jackson, right? But I have never seen it, so thank you. Oh my god. You guys. It's the Steelbook of Coraline. It's the brand new one that the studio just put out. They just did the theatrical re-release of Coraline and it was a hit. They made like $6 million or something just on the re-release alone. And I think that it was partially to promote their new 4K like Steelbook collection. So that studio also did, I think, Paranorman as well. And I can't remember what else, maybe Box Trolls or something. So definitely check them out. I would kill a man for this steelbook, and it was sent to me for free. Thank you, John. Okay, we got a couple of Blu-rays left here. We've got The Fly. This is from 1958, and I do already own this one. So again, eyes peeled for the anti-haul. Next up, we've got I Am Legend. You know, I keep seeing this movie in Goodwill. I keep seeing it on DVD on the shelves, and I keep passing it up, even though I've been wanting to rewatch it, because the only time I ever watched it, I was a kid, and it scared the hell out of me back then. I don't think that it would now, but I remember enjoying it. So I've been wanting to rewatch it. I've been wanting to own it, but this is much better than picking up an old crusty DVD from Goodwill. So thanks. And I think this is last up from John's package. Yes, we have, ooh, The Crazies on Blu-ray. I can't remember. I think that I own this movie on Blu-ray, but if I owned it on DVD, then this will be an upgrade. Either way, one of them will be in an anti-haul soon. Okay, another great box from John. We've got one more to go. Oh, this is the heaviest one, and it is from Rob Ostrander. I think he sent me something before. My mom had already torn that up, so that was pretty easy. Oh, there's some books in here. Hold on a minute. Okay, I need to pull everything out because this is just, the box is too big. It's making me sit all awkward. All right, I've got a little stack here. And first up we have, it's The Great Pumpkin Charlie Brown. This is on Blu-ray. And believe it or not, I don't know if I've ever actually seen the whole thing. I feel like at some point, maybe when I was in elementary school or something, I probably did, like at school. I don't know, but I've never owned it. And so this is so special. Thank you. And I really like that it's like raised. There's the artwork is raised and you know, it's, you can feel it. It's bumpy. I don't know why, but I like that a lot. Next up, we have Silent Night, Deadly Night. Ooh, a little sticker just came out. Look at this little sticker. Oh my God, I love it. Thank you. I do think that I've seen this one. It's been a little while and I know that it is 100% like a cult classic. This is the original unrated version too. If you haven't seen this one, I do recommend it. It is kind of an underrated little gem. Next up, we have Scanners. Oh my God, look at this like sleeved edition of this David Cronenberg classic. Ooh, this is falling out. Oh, it's a little booklet. If you know me, you know that I love when things come with a little booklet. Oh yes, love it, love it. Oh, this would be great for a David Cronenberg deep dive, absolutely. The artwork is very good. It's very good. I don't know why, it kind of reminds me of like Rick and Morty a little bit. And then here is the inside of the case. This is the Criterion Collection edition, so I don't know why I was like acting surprised that it's so well done. Three separate DVDs in here. That is curious. It's Criterion, so you already know that there's just like a ton of crazy special features in here. Got a lot of Criterion Collection stuff, actually. The next one is Repo Man. This one I've never seen, but I've certainly heard of it. It is from 1984. When you slide it out, the artwork is so cool. Look at that. Of course, this one also has, oh, this one's got a big, thick booklet. This is like a mini little book in here. Wow. It's mostly artwork, and then there's also information, but there's like pages of the script and stuff. Very comic book vibes in here. I like it a lot. I like it a lot, a lot. Criterion Collection just always does such a good job of making things super unique. I gotta go a little bit quicker. Let me not dwell so long on these. Next up, we have Brain Damage. This is Arrow Video, one of my favorite boutique labels. Brain Damage is not a movie that I've seen. I think this one is from the 90s. No, 1988, my bad. Yeah, of course. I mean, it's Arrow Video, so it's just a really good looking little case here. And you got the info booklet. I won't keep pulling them out, don't worry. Next up, what is this? Ooh! John Carpenter's Halloween, the 35th anniversary edition. I've never seen this before in my life. This is, in fact, a Blu-ray, too. This is what's in there when you first open it, and then it's like a little book with pictures, some of the famous behind-the-scenes pictures, and some of the info. Oh, look at this! Look at this! Oh, that's different. The DVD is in this little slip part of it right here. All new HD transfer supervised and approved by cinematographer Dean Cundey. New audio commentary with writer-director John Carpenter and actor Jamie Lee Curtis. On location 25 years later featurette, The Night She Came Home featurette, TV version footage, TV and radio spot. Wow, there's a lot of stuff on here that I don't think I've even seen before. And I've done a lot of research into this movie. Next up, another Criterion Collection edition, we have The Devil's Backbone. I've been sent a lot of stuff that I have not seen. My watch list, it groweth, it spilleth over. Oh, the inside of this is gorgeous. Look at, I love that DVD artwork. Keeping things moving right along, we also have Dazed and Confused up next, the Criterion Collection edition. I do already have this exact same edition and I love it so much. Now I'll be able to give it to somebody else for a heavily discounted rate. That's wonderful. Oh my God. The next one, it's the first four movies of the Alien franchise. Oh my God, look at it, and it's so pretty. This thing also is so sturdy too. This thing feels like a brick. That is heavy, babes. The first four movies, let's see what's in here. Ooh, it's genuinely, it's a book. So look at that, and then look at that, and then look at, let's look at this. Okay, wait, I have to look at it too, because I want to react to it too. Oh, wow, gorgeous, ooh. Oh, it still smells new. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Sorry, I probably wasn't holding it up high enough. Sorry, my bad. Let's start over. Got caught off guard by the smell. Had to give it a big old whiff. But it's beautiful. Look at the, ooh, and it changes color. I love this. This is so well done. And what's such a bummer is I just shot my top 10 favorites in my physical media collection, but I pre-recorded it for when I'm gonna be out of the country. And this probably would have made that list. That's what's so sad about it. You also get this little little thing called the Alien Anthology Mother Mode Viewer's Guide. All right, god damn. There's literally two separate discs here that have the special features. That's crazy. Oh, I love it. I love it so much. Thank you. Next up, oh, The Fog on Blu-ray. I have this movie on Blu-ray, but it's part of a double feature, so I won't be able to get rid of that because the other movie on that double feature is The Howling, so gotta hold on to it, obviously, but I'll probably hold on to this one too. I'll eventually get an upgrade of The Howling and have them separately. I really like the artwork on this. Nice little re-release artwork. Next up we have, oh, Django Unchained. I have never seen this movie either. Again, let me know if you want me to make this part of my I Finally Watched series. This is a really nice Blu-ray edition, a lot of special features. It's sleeved. I love it. Oh, more Quentin Tarantino. It's Pulp Fiction. This is probably the most egregious thing that's gonna be part of my I Finally Watched series because somehow I've never seen this movie. I think it's probably the one that people are usually the most surprised about that I haven't seen, because I've seen like all of horror, but this is one classic film that people are like, what? You were a film student and you never what? I know. So thank you for making it so much easier for me. I know that I think it's on streaming right now, but I always gravitate towards my physical media collection before I see what's on streaming. So that's one of the reasons why I've put this off for so long. So thank you. You've expedited the process. Last but not least, we have a book, and this would be The Dead Zone. This is a Stephen King book that I have not read. There is so much catching up to do though with that man. He puts out like 2 or 3 books a year, so you can't blame me for not getting to this one yet. I'm working my way through it though, so thank you. Every book takes me one step closer to catching up. I actually don't know what this one is about, so I think it'll be fun to go into this one blind. Hello, sorry to butt in here, but I actually ended up receiving a few more packages while I was editing this video. So I thought that I might as well include them because it's gonna be another several months before I have an opportunity to shoot a subscriber mail unboxing. So let's just get to it and then we'll get back to my outro. This one's from a Theodore Burt. It feels like a DVD. What do you know? It's a DVD of Girls Ain't Boys. I don't know what this is, but it literally just looks like I Spit on Your Grave, and somebody sent me a bajillion movies in that franchise recently. And I have no idea if it was the same person. I truly don't know, because all those came in unmarked packages. Oh my god, the lead is Danielle Panabaker? I love her. And it's a revenge movie, so I don't know. Sue me for thinking this sounds pretty similar to I Spit on Your Grave. Next up, we have a package from a Dolores Pinzino from all the way in Brooklyn, New York. This one's a book, and it's called Shock Around the Clock, Timely Tales of Terror by David H. Dorian. This looks a lot like all of those little 80s classic anthology books that I received several months ago. I already just completely blew through those, so I guess it was time that I got another one. I am currently reading Dracula right now, but I could probably blow through this in like a single evening, and I'll get back to you about it, so thank you. Just a couple more items here. Thank you for allowing me to butt in. Now, back to the outro. That's it though. That's gonna do it for my subscriber unboxing for today. The piles on my desk are really precarious, but here's some of it. Thank you so much to my lovely cult members for sending this along. I've got some amazing things to add to my collection, and also I just love getting mail. So I really hope that you guys enjoyed watching this unboxing. Again, if you want more content from me, check out the Haunted Hippie channel. If you prefer movie reviews and stuff like that, then that's the place to be. If you want even more movie reviews and other fun rankings and such content, then follow the Patreon. Everything you need is always listed down below, including my social media. But more than anything, I just hope that you enjoyed this video and that I catch you in the next one. Bye!